Hi all, welcome back. This is the third part of the lecture on mass transfer. In the first two parts, we have studied one-dimensional steady-state diffusion mass transfer through plane wall, cylindrical and spherical coordinates. And also, we have discussed some numerical problems. Today, we are going to discuss a special case of diffusion mass transfer in the first half. And then we go through the mode of mass transfer by phase change process. And finally, we'll discuss some problems. So let's start with steady state equimolar counter diffusion. This is a special case of diffusion mass transfer. That is, in this case, the mixer is at a constant pressure and temperature throughout. The equimolar counter diffusion between species A and B of a binary gas mixture is defined as an isothermal diffusion process in which each molecule of component A is replaced by each molecule of component B and vice versa. Consider two large chambers A and B connected by a passage of length L shown in figure. The entire system contains a binary mixture of gases A and B at uniform temperature and pressure throughout. The concentrations of species are maintained constant in each reservoir such that YA0, that is the mole fraction of species A at this point, is greater than mole fraction of species A at this point. And YB0, that is the mole fraction of species B at this point, is less than YBL, that is the mole fraction of species B at this point. So the concentration of species A is more at this point. It is less at this point. So there is a concentration difference here. Same way, concentration of species B is more at this tank and it is less here. Because of these concentration gradients, species A diffuse in the positive x direction and B in the opposite direction. Now assume both gases are ideal gases and thus P is equal to rho RT. So this R, characteristic gas constant, we can represent in terms of universal gas constant G. That is G by molecular weight of the component. So we know that rho by molecular weight will give you the molar concentration or molar density of that component. So you can represent pressure, the total pressure of the mixture P is equal to CGT. In this case, P, T and G, that is a universal gas constant, all are constant, so we can say the total molar concentration of the mixture C equal to CA plus CB, that will be equal to a constant. To maintain the total molar concentration C constant throughout, it requires for each molecule of A that moves to the right, a molecule of B moves to the left, and thus the molar flow rate of species A and B must be equal in magnitude and opposite in sign. That is, Na equal to minus Nb. B is diffusing in the opposite direction, so it is denoted with minus N. Or Na plus Nb is equal to 0. So this process is called equimolar counter diffusion. The net molar flow rate of the mixture for such process and thus the molar average velocity is 0. So here we can see a partial pressure diagram with respect to distance. At left tank, partial pressure of species B is less and partial pressure of species A is more. At the right tank, partial pressure of species B is higher value and partial pressure of species A is less. So this is the variation of partial pressure of each species. The total pressure of the mixture is constant throughout the system. So using Fick's law, we can represent mass flux in terms of partial pressure. MA by A is equal to minus DAB MA by GT into dPA by DX. And MB by A is equal to minus DBA MB by GT dPB by DX. These equations you can find from the data book page number 183, equation 3. These equations we have already discussed in the previous part of the lecture. So we know that P is equal to total pressure P is equal to sum of its partial pressures of its components dA plus pb. So dp by dx is equal to dpa by dx plus dpb by dx. Since the total pressure remains constant under steady state conditions, we have dp by dx is equal to 0. If it is constant, dp by dx is equal to 0. So you will get dpa by dx is equal to minus dpb by dx. Also under steady state conditions, total molar flux relative to stationary coordinates must be 0. Thus, Na by A plus Nb by A is equal to 0. That means Na by A is equal to minus Nb by A. Now, we can rewrite the equation number 1 in terms of molar flux, because molar flux is equal to mass flux by molecular weight. The equation number 1 becomes, in terms of molar flux, Na by A is equal to minus DAB by GT dP by PA by DX, and NB by A equal to minus DBA by GT dPB by DX. So equation number 3, Na by A is equal to minus DAB by GT dPA by DX equal to minus of NB by A, that is minus of minus dBA by GT dPB by DX. So it will be positive. Now substitute the value of dPA by DX from equation number 2 in this equation. You can cancel this dPB by DX, dPB by DX. These two minus signs will be positive. And GT, GT you can cancel. Finally you will get dAB equal to dBA. That is equal to D. So this means that for equimolar diffusion in a boundary system, the diffusion coefficient dAB and dBA are equal. So assuming D is constant and integrating the equation number 1, that is the Fick's law, between two points, that is at x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. At x is equal to 0 is denoted with the suffix 1 and x is equal to L denoted with the suffix 2. If we integrate it between the points 1 to 2, MA by A is equal to minus dMA by GT integral 1 to 2 dPA by DX, and you will get the equation for mass flux is equal to minus dAB MA by GT within bracket PA1 minus PA2 divided by X2 minus X1. And MB by A is equal to minus DAB. Both these diffusion coefficients are same. So minus DAB, MB by GT, PB2 minus PB1 divided by X2 minus X1. This equation you can find from the data book page number 183, equation number 4, where instead of MA by G, they have used 1 by RA, where RA is the characteristic gas constant of species A. Also, we can represent this equation in terms of mole fraction. You will get this equation. Same way, we can represent in terms of partial pressures. You will get this equation. Here, Ru, the term Ru is a universal gas constant G, which is the ratio of mass of species A to the molecular mass of species A. Now, we will discuss one problem in this topic. NH3 and air are in equimolar diffusion through a cylindrical tube of 3.5 millimeter diameter and 2.5 meter length. The total pressure is 1 atmosphere and the temperature is 27 degrees Celsius. One end of the tube is connected with a large NH3 tank and the other end is open to the atmosphere. Calculate the mass transfer rate of NH3 and air through the tube. So from data book page number 189, you can find the diffusion coefficient for NH3 air. So DAB is equal to, which is DAB is equal to 21.60 into 10 raised to minus 6 meter square per second. Let suffix A for NH3 and suffix B for air. Just draw the system here. Tank A having NH3 at 1 atmosphere and tank B having air at same pressure, 1 atmosphere. The distance of the tube connected these two tanks is given as 25 meter length and 3.5 millimeter diameter tube. At the atmosphere, initially the NH3 is 0. So in the tank, only air is there. In the tank 1, only NH3 is there initially. So P1 is equal to 1 atmosphere, atmospheric pressure at this point 1. PA2, that is the partial pressure of NH3 at this point, is 0 initially. Temperature is 27 degrees Celsius, that is 300 Kelvin. Now you can use this equation, Na is equal to, from data book page number 183, equation 4. Actually, in data book, you can find this equation, MA by A is equal to DAB by RAT, PA1 minus PA2 divided by Y2 minus Y1. Here, they are using Y2 and Y1 instead of X2 and X1. This distance is represented with the Y2 minus Y1. MA by molecular weight, that is NA, is equal to, you will get this equation, DABAGT, PA1 minus PA2 divided by X2 minus X1. All these values we have now, you can find out NA, the molar concentration rate. Area is the cross section area of the pipe, that is pi by 4 d square. PA1, PA2, we know the distance, X2 minus X1 is 25 meter. G is 8314 joule per kilogram Kelvin. And the temperature should be in Kelvin here. So you will get 3.38 in 10 to minus 13 kilogram mole per second. Now, to find the mass flow rate of NH3, you should multiply this molar flow rate with the molecular weight of the NH3. So molecular weight of NH3 and air, you can find from the data book page number 192. So it is 17.03 kilogram per kilogram mole for NH3 and 28.96 kilogram per kilogram mole for air. So if you multiply the molar flow rate with the molecular weight of, you will get the mass flow rate of NH3, that will be 5.75 into 10 raised to minus 2 kilogram per second. And for the mass flow rate of air, NA multiplied with the molecular weight of air, that is 28.96. So you will get 9.79 into 10 raised to minus 12 kilogram per second. Or you can use the same equation from the data book. Here 1 by RA equal to MA by G. MA is 17.03. G is constant for all gases, 8314. So 17.03 by 8314, you will get the 1 by RA value for ammonia. And you can substitute that value directly here. Either way, you can find the answer. So now we move on to another topic. Diffusion of vapor through a stationary gas. Several mass transfer applications such as heat pipes, cooling ponds, etc. involve the diffusion of one vapor through another non-diffusing gas. For example, humidification of air, in which water vapor diffuse from the air-water interface through an air layer which is stationary or stagnant. In your syllabus, isothermal evaporation of water vapor through air only included. However, it is applicable for other cases also. So we will discuss isothermal evaporation of water vapor through air in this topic. This case is actually an example of mass transfer associated with the phase change process. Here also, the total pressure and temperature of the mixture is held constant, and thus the molar concentration capital C of the mixer remains constant as we discussed in the previous topic. Now let us consider an isothermal evaporation of water from a surface and its subsequent diffusion through a stagnant layer of air over it as shown in figure. So this is a tank which is having water, liquid A is water in our case, and we have a stagnant air column from the water surface to the top of the tank. This is the condition. So this interface is our datum level, x is equal to 0, and the top of the tank is x is equal to L. Okay, these are the two locations we are going to consider. For the analysis of this type of mass diffusion, following assumptions are made. The first assumption is the system is under steady state and isothermal condition. Temperature is constant throughout the system. The total pressure within the system is also constant. That is PA plus PW equal to P, which is constant throughout from the interface to the top of the tank. Air as well as water vapor behaves as an ideal gas. There is a slight air movement over the top of the tank to remove the water vapor which diffuses to that point. Now, the water concentration at the surface of water is much more compared to that at the top of the tank. So these are the assumptions. Equilibrium exists between liquid and vapor phases at the interface. At the interface means x is equal to 0, the location 1. So the vapor pressure at the interface must be equal to the saturation pressure of liquid. In our case, it is water. Saturation pressure of water at the specified temperature. We already assumed that it is isothermal condition. So at the specified temperature, vapor pressure of water at the water surface is the saturation pressure of the water. Assume the air to be insoluble in the liquid. If the air at the top of the tank, that is at x is equal to L, the location 2, is not saturated, the vapor pressure at the interface is greater than that at the top of the tank. Atmospheric air can hold a maximum amount of water vapor at a specified temperature. If it is holding the maximum amount of water vapor at the specified temperature, then it is called saturated air. Now, at the interface, it is saturated air, but at the top of the tank, the air is not saturated. So, there is a pressure difference here. There is PW1, vapor pressure of water at the interface. PW1 is greater than PW2, and thus YW1 is greater than YW2, where YW1 is the mole fraction of water at the interface. So YW1 is greater than YW2, that means there is a concentration difference of water vapor at the interface and at the top of the tank. And the pressure of the system is constant throughout. At the location 1, that is this point, at the location 1, PW is higher than that of PA. From here to here, this is PW, and this much distance represents PA. So total pressure PW plus PA, which is constant throughout in the air column. This is the air column from 1 to 2. So that is represented here, 1 to 2. So because of the pressure and temperature is constant, we know that the molar concentration constant throughout the air column from the interface to the top of the tank. Now if YW1 is greater than YW2, and thus the air mole fractions YA1 should be less than that of YA2. Air concentration is more at the top of the tank and it is less at the interface. So there is a concentration difference of air and also the concentration difference of water vapor, but both are opposite direction. Now under steady state conditions, because of the concentration difference of water vapor at the interface and the top of the tank, there is an upward diffusion of water vapor that must be balanced by a downward diffusion of air, so that The concentration at any distance from the water surface remains constant. So the pressure difference or concentration difference will drive the water vapor upward from the interface through the stagnant air column. The upward flow of vapor will be sustained by the evaporation of water at the interface. Under steady state conditions, the upward movement of water must be balanced by the downward diffusion of air so that concentration at any distance from the water surface remains constant. The mass diffusion of air in the downward direction is given by the Fick's law, ma down equal to minus d a ma by gt dpa by dx. Put this as equation number 1, where a is the cross section area of the tank, dpa by dx is the partial pressure gradient of air. Since there is no mass movement of air downward at the surface of water, there will be a bulk mass movement upward with a velocity to compensate for the mass diffusion of the air downward, so that the net molar or mass diffusion rate of the air at any point is zero. In other words, upward bulk motion offsets the downward diffusion of air, and for each air molecule that moves downward, there is another air molecule that moves upward. As a result, the air column appears to be stagnant in this case. So we can write down the bulk mass transfer of air upward, ma up equal to, if it is at a velocity u, then it is rho a u. Rho a, density of air, cross section area of the tank, and the velocity of the bulk fluid motion u, that is equal to minus pa ma by gt a into u, where u is the bulk velocity upward. Put this as equation number 2. So equating 1 and 2, so here the downward movement of air should be equal to the upward movement of air along with the bulk mass movement. So you can equate these two equations 1 and 2. We will get dA ma by gt dpa by dx is equal to pa ma by gt au. You can find out the velocity of the bulk fluid. U is equal to d by pa dpa by dx. Put this as equation number 3. Now, the bulk motion of gas means it transport vapor as well as the gas upward with a velocity u, which results additional mass flow of vapor upward. So the total mass transport of water vapor should be equal to the sum of upward mass diffusion of water and water vapor carried along with bulk movement of air. Therefore, the total mass transport of water vapor equal to minus dA mw by gt dpw by dx plus the upward movement of water vapor will be rho w au. You can substitute the value of u from equation number 2 here. You will get minus dA mw by gt dpw by dx plus this equation. And according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, p is equal to pa plus pw. Upon differentiation, you will get dp by dx is equal to dpa by dx plus dpw by dx. Since the total pressure in the tank remains constant, dp by dx is equal to 0. So you get dpa by dx is equal to minus dpw by dx. Substitute this value in this equation and simplify. You will get dA mw by gt into dp by w by dx. Both these terms are constant. And minus is also constant. Take it outside. Within bracket, you will get 1 plus Pw by Pa. Take LCM here. And you will get Pa plus Pw divided by P minus Pw. Where Pa is at the denominator, which is P minus Pw. You will get Mw total equal to minus dA Mw by GT dPw by DX. Multiplied with P by P minus Pw. This equation is known as Stefan's law of diffusion of an ideal gaseous component to a stagnant and ideal component of the binary system. Now integrate the above equation between in the locations 1 and 2, we have mw total multiplied with integral x1 to x2 dx is equal to minus dA mw by gt into p multiplied with pw1 to pw2 integral pw1 pw2 d pw by p minus pw, where pw is varying from the interface to the top of the tank and the distance also varying from interface to the top of the tank. So integrate, you will get mw total multiplied with x2 minus x1 is equal to, this integration will give you ln of pw2 minus p divided by pw1 minus p. When you rearrange the equation, you will get where p minus pw2 divided by p minus pw1 is pa2 and pa1. So you will get the equation mw total is equal to dab a mw by gt p by x2 minus x1, which is the height of the air column, multiplied with ln of pa2 by pa1. But this was equation number 6. This equation you can find from the data book, page number 193, equation 5. Now, we know that the partial pressure of air and partial pressure of water vapor is varying from the interface of the air and water towards the top of the tank. The partial pressure of water vapor is decreasing from the interface to the top of the tank. At the same time, the partial pressure of air is increasing from the interface to the top of the tank. And the total pressure remains constant throughout. P is equal to PA plus PW. Water is moving from interface to the top of the tank. Air is moving from the top to the interface downwards. So these variations of partial pressure is not a linear variation. So we can assume a logarithmic mean partial pressure of air, LMPA. Yes, recall LMTD, logarithmic mean temperature difference, in case of heat exchangers we have already derived in the fourth module. Same way you can define a logarithmic mean partial pressure of air, LMPA, which I am denoting with a PA here. In data book, it is denoted with a PBM, PBM. So PA is equal to PA2 minus PA1 divided by ln of PA2 by PA1. This equation is same as that of LMTD. So that is equal to PA2 is equal to P minus PW2 and PA1 is equal to P minus PW1. So this minus and this minus sign, P minus PW1, will be positive. So you will get LMPA, logarithmic mean partial pressure of air, equal to PW1 minus PW2 divided by ln of PA2 by PA1. So ln of PA2 by PA1 is equal to PW1 minus PW2 divided by PA. Now substitute this value of ln of PA2 by PA1 in equation number 6. You will get the final equation, mass transport, mass diffusion from the interface to the top of the tank through the stagnant air column, equal to dAV A mw by gt p by x2 minus x1, that is the height of the air column from the interface to the tank, multiplied with pw1 minus pw2 divided by pa. Here pw1 is the partial pressure of water vapor at the interface, pw2 is the partial pressure of water vapor at the top of the tank, pa is the LMPA, that is logarithmic mean partial pressure of air, which is equal to PA2 minus PA1 divided by ln of PA2 by PA1. Or P is the total pressure of the system, MW is the molecular weight of water vapor, A is the cross-section area of the tank, dAB is the diffusion coefficient, G is the universal gas constant, and T is the temperature of the total system. So this equation also you can find from the data book, page number 183, but careful, that equation is wrong in data book. The correct equation is this one. in the data book, this term is missing. MA by IC equals DAB by RAT, P by Y2 minus Y1, PA2 minus PA1 divided by PBM, where A is the diffusing component. In our case, it is water vapor. And Y2 minus Y1 is the distance from the interface to the top of the tank. And here, 1 by RA is MW by G. So this is RW actually, water vapor characteristic gas constant, that is MW by G. Now let's discuss some problems in this topic. First problem is, calculate the rate of diffusion of water vapor from a pool of water at the bottom of a well 6 meter in height to dry air flowing over the top of the well. Assume the entire system is at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere. If the well dia is 3 meter, find the total weight of water diffused per hour from the surface of the water in the well. Take diffusion coefficient D is equal to 0.256 centimeter square per second. So here in this problem, they have given the well height is 6 meter. But we know from the derivation of this topic, the height we have considered here should be from the interface to the top of the tank. So take this distance as 6 meter. And diameter of the well is 3 meter. It is given. So x1 in this case is equal to 0 and x2 is equal to 6 meter. From x1, x2 minus x1 is 6 meter now. This is our equation. MW total is equal to dA MW by GT P by x2 minus x1 ln of PA2 by PA1. So we need to find out PA2 and PA1. PA2 is the partial pressure of air at the top of the tank and PA1 is the partial pressure of air at the freeze surface of water. So we know that PA1 is equal to P total pressure minus the partial pressure of water vapor at the location 1. Here at the interface, partial pressure of water vapor is the saturation vapor pressure of water at the given temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius in this problem. So PW1 is the saturation pressure of water vapor at 25 degrees Celsius. That value is equal to 0.03166 bar, which you can find from the steam table. So both the steam table and the data book is needed to solve these type of problems. So you will get PA1 is equal to, it is given that the total pressure is 1 atmosphere, so that is 1.01325 bar minus 0.032, that will be equal to 0.98 bar. Now PA2 equal to P minus PW2. At the top of the tank, the vapor pressure of water is 0 in this case because dry air is flowing over the top of the well. Dry air means there is no water vapor in the air. So the partial pressure of water vapor is 0 at the top of the tank. So you will get 1.01325 bar as PA2. Now you can directly use this equation. MW you know that is 18, and diffusion coefficient in this problem is given in the unit centimeter square per second, so convert it to meter square per second, so multiply it with 10 raised to minus 4, and G value is 8314 joule per mole Kelvin, and T is equal to 25 degrees Celsius, that is 298 Kelvin. Substitute all the values here and calculate, you will get 0.016 kilogram per hour. Second problem, an open pan 15 centimeter in diameter and 7.5 centimeter deep contains water at 25 degrees Celsius and is exposed to atmospheric air at 25 degrees Celsius and 50% relative humidity. Note this point, 50% relative humidity. Calculate the evaporation rate of water. So this is the figure. Here an open pan 15 centimeter in diameter is 15 centimeter, so it is 0.15 meter and 7.5 centimeter deep. So this depth should be taken as the height of the air column It is given as the relative humidity is 50%. Relative humidity is denoted with the letter phi, which means atmospheric air contains only 50% of water vapor it can hold at 25 degrees Celsius. So that means it is not fully saturated condition and it is not fully dry condition. It is holding 50% of water vapor it can actually hold at 25 degrees Celsius. So at 25 degrees Celsius, the partial pressure of water vapor is 0.03166 bar from steam table. So PW1 pressure of water vapor at the interface will be 0.03166 bar, which is fully saturated condition. And at the top, the air is not fully saturated, it is not fully dry. So it is holding 50% of air it can hold at 25 degrees Celsius. If it is holding the maximum amount of water vapor, then partial pressure of water vapor will be 0.03166 bar. So if air is holding only 50%, then its partial pressure will be 50% of the maximum partial pressure it have at 25 degrees Celsius. So that is PW2 is equal to 5 into PW1. That is equal to 0.01583 bar. Now you can find out PA1, PA2, P minus PW1 and P minus PW2. You will get 0.98159 bar, 0.99742 bar. And just substitute the value here. This equation you can find from the data page number 183. In this problem, D value is not given. So you can find the diffusion coefficient value for water to air at 26 degrees Celsius from the data of page number 189. This value 25.83 into 10 raised to minus 6 meters square per second. Substitute all the values. So you will get 7.164 into 10 raised to minus 8 kilogram per second. The next problem, determine the rate of evaporation of toluene from bottom of a deep narrow vessel. Depth is equal to 1.525 meter per area into dry stagnant air at 19 degrees Celsius. The partial pressure of toluene vapor is 0.026. Take D value, diffusion coefficient is 0.826 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter square per second. So toluene, partial pressure of toluene at the free surface is equal to 0.026 atmosphere. PT2, because it is dry air at the top of the tank, toluene partial pressure is 0. PA1 is equal to 1 minus 0.026, that is equal to 0.974 atmosphere. PA2 at this point, PA2 is equal to 1 atmosphere. D is given. Substitute the values here. This molecular weight, so MT is the molecular weight of the diffusing component, which is toluene in this problem. So molecular weight of toluene is equal to 92.13, which you can find from the data book page number 192 to 193. Toluene value is in page number 193. So substitute all these values, you will get mass flux of toluene is equal to 5.49 into 10 raised to minus 7 kilogram per meter square second. The last problem, a 40 millimeter deep pan is filled with water to a level of 15 millimeter and is exposed to dry air at 40 degrees Celsius. Assuming the mass diffusivity as 0.25 into 10 raised to minus 4 meter square per second, calculate the time required for all water to evaporate. So in this problem, they have given the pan is totally 40 millimeter deep and the water is filled up to a level of 15 millimeter. So this 15 millimeter is x1 and 40 meter is x2. Now we need to find the time required for all water to evaporate. So find PA1 first. PA1 is equal to P minus PW1, where PW1 is the saturation pressure of water vapor at 40 degrees Celsius from the steam table. That is equal to 0.07375 bar. You can calculate PA1, which is 0.9395 bar. And at the top of the tank, the air is dry. So PA2 is equal to 1.0125 bar because PW2 is 0 there because it is dry air. Now so we have the equation MW total is equal to this equation. All the values we have D value here, they are not given the diameter of the pan, so just substitute A itself and now you will get a value of MW total in terms of area, that is equal to 5.296 × −5 multiplied with the area of cross section of the pan in kilogram per seconds. Now the total amount of water to be evaporated is equal to up to 15 millimeter height water is there, so total this much amount of water should be evaporated, so that is equal to rho v, that is rho w multiplied with area into length. Here the length is 15 millimeter and area is the cross section area, so you will get in kilogram 15 multiplied with area, that much kilogram of water should be evaporated from the pan. So here you already got the evaporation rate of water in terms of area. Here you have got the total mass of water evaporated in terms of area. So time required will be equal to the total amount of water to be evaporated per the evaporation rate, that is 15 into A divided by 5.296 × 10⁻⁵ A, 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 you can cancel, you will get 283.2 × 10�³ seconds or 78.67 hour. Time required for all water to evaporate in this problem is 78.67 hour. Thank you. The next and the last topic of this module we will discuss in the next part.